Good evening. Excellent. Welcome to the first jazz concert for the 2012 fall semester. This is the 4 o'clock jazz band. Don't they look good? My name is Mike McMullen, and I will be your host for this short part of the program. I asked them to dress up for you. Do you think they did a good job? I think they look good, and they're going to sound really good, too. We're going to start with a tune entitled Cubism. That's okay. I don't know what it means either. It's written by Chris Mertz, and it will feature Christian Celis on the piano and Aaron Asmus on the alto saxophone. Thank you. Thank you. Christian Sellis, piano. Aaron Asmus on the alto saxophone. Kubism. We're going to go to something a little bit more familiar now. How many of you are familiar with Herbie Hancock? Okay, we have a few. This is good. Herbie Hancock had a groundbreaking album some years ago entitled Maiden Voyage. And one of the pieces on that album was a tune that's become a jazz standard. This is entitled Dolphin Dance. This is a Bob Mintzer arrangement of Dolphin Dance. Bob Mintzer, in addition to being a member of the Yellow Jackets and a very high-profile soloist in the jazz world, is also a very, very good big band writer and had a band for many years in New York. This will feature Joe Epstein on the trumpet and Morgan Childers.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to continue. I think no concert is complete without something classic. I could have said old, I suppose.
You don't want to say that.
Yeah. Would you believe he's still in middle school? They're twins. Okay. I firmly believe in tradition, in connecting the music and the bands to the legacy. And this is a piece written by Mike Lewis in the Basie style and, of course, dedicated to Count Basie. This is entitled One More for the Count. It will feature Fritz Heilbronn. Thank you. Basie. Yeah. Now we're going to play one of my favorite tunes, I think, at least from one of my favorite composers. This is a Thelonious Monk composition. Some years ago, Bill Holman decided to tackle the work of Monk, and his compositions are played quite a bit in the jazz world these days, but something that he said in the liner notes on the album was that not a lot of composers really took Monk and worked the music through compositional principles and developed arrangements and just, you know, he talked about trying to make the music grow in a compositionally developmental way. I don't know how to say this. So it's really to develop the story of the songs, because a lot of Monk's tunes are sort of these quirky things that they're based on these little riffs or something, and they do these a few times, and they go up and down a bit, and then we have a great time playing them. And this particular one, he sticks pretty close to the tune because of the harmonic richness, but much of the rest of the album he really develops a lot with and does some very surprising things where the tunes are almost unrecognizable and yet still Monk and fantastically beautiful music. This is a composition entitled Ruby, My Dear. It's a beautiful Monk composition. We're going to open this with Vibes with Peter Bell and Jessica Luna accompanying. And this will also feature Brian Swart on the tenor and Aaron Smith on the trumpet. Ruby, My Dear.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, we've got one final number tonight. Imagine if Dizzy Gillespie and Tito Puente got together. Dizzy did have that Universal World Orchestra, I think, and he was highly influenced by the Latin music. This is a classic Dizzy Gillespie composition entitled Burke's Works, done in a Latin style. This is arranged by Mike Tomorrow, and it will feature Brian Swart again and Joe Epstein. Thank you. The 4 o'clock big band. 4 o'clock big band. Joe Epstein, Brian Swart. Excellent. We're going to have a very short interval. Very short interval, and the 1:30 big band will be up, so please stick around.